Good morning. Welcome to camp. I need to get you all caught up with what's going on right now. So I am on a 3-day backpacking trip here in the desert. This is Capitol Reef National Park, and we hiked in yesterday to this spot about 9-ish miles, I think just under 9 miles. And we're actually gonna stay in this spot today and then do a really cool day hike through a slot canyon and camp here another night and then hike out tomorrow. So that's kind of the scope of this trip. And today I just want to show you all of the delicious backpacking food that I packed to eat all day today. So we're talking breakfast, lunch, dinner, snacks, dessert, all the things. I'm going to take you along on my day. First up is coffee. And so let me show you where I want to have coffee today. This is one of the views. And I decided that this morning I wanted to hike up on this rock here and have coffee up there, because why not have coffee with an epic view? The sun is also working its way down these rocks, and so I think it will get up there a lot faster than it's going to get down where I currently am. Coffee with an epic view. I mean, does it get any better than this? There's like no way my head would be in this frame.
No, it's cut off.
I am on coffee cup number 2, and I usually try to drink no more than 2 cups a day. So after this, I'm gonna have some breakfast. It is such a beautiful morning, like the bright sunshine, the weather is perfect. It's not too cold. For breakfast today, I have a no-cook breakfast, and it's cereal. So I packed in some cereal here. I'm actually pretty surprised that it is not more broken up from a full day in my pack, but I have that here. And then this is a little bit of powdered milk and some freeze-dried bananas. And I'm just gonna mix all of this together with some cold filtered water in a bowl, and breakfast is done. This is a really nice way to just have, again, a no-cook breakfast in the backcountry, and you can pack different types of cereals for all the different days and just kind of have a little bit of variety but still keep things really, really simple and delicious. So after some mixing, all of that powdered milk goes into the water. And I forgot to tell you, I put some raisins in here as well, but it's just this huge bowl of cereal with some bananas. So easy.
So good. I'm one of those weird people that likes their cereal a little bit soggy. So this is like perfect for me right now. Nick is also having cereal. He has like a Honey Bunches of Oats kind of vibe. And then I put some freeze-dried strawberries in his. So it's super easy to mix it up and customize. Is it good?
Mm-hmm.
We are starting the hike. It is 3 miles of Slot Canyon, and I am so excited.
Look at this tree. Just so tall and strong and majestic.
So these canyon walls, anytime we do a Slot Canyon thing, it's just so hard to show how tall these walls are. You just feel like a little ant in a little ant farm. It's crazy. Oh gosh, it's so cold. That was the deepest one yet. It was about mid-thigh. It is cold. We're getting to the last little section of the Slot Canyon, which is gonna be chest deep water. And I'm starting to feel nervous because I know it's going to be really cold. Yeah. We are entering, I think, the deepest section here. Whew. We made it out of the Slot Canyon and now we're going to have some lunch and dry everything off. So I have my shirt right here getting dry. Nick is down there getting some water and I'm gonna get lunch ready. This is everything that I packed for lunch today. So I'm having the usual Safe Catch. This is actually a salmon packet in the rosemary Dijon and it's so good. And so I'm gonna have that with these crackers that I packed in here. Okay, these are pretzel crackers. So I packed those in and actually they look like they survived the journey yesterday okay. So I'm gonna also have some olives and these are my favorite sausages right now. These Duke's original recipe ones are so, so good. I'm not gonna eat that right now. And then I also have these little wild berry twisted fruit rope. Got this at Target. They're so good and tangy. So I'm gonna have all of that for lunch in the sunshine as I dry off. And then we gotta finish the hike back to camp. Nick just went and filtered some more water. And I put a Noon tablet in there because I just love the electrolytes and the taste of the Noon tablets. These pretzel chips, I don't understand how we are so late to the game with them, but they are good. We are back at camp and I'm having another bottle of water with a Noon tablet in it. I just love the taste and I feel like with the electrolytes in there, I drink more water, and especially out here in the desert where I'm sweating a lot and it's very dry, it's easy to get dehydrated. So I'm just drinking that. And then I am also having, big surprise, a Power Crunch bar. You guys know I love these. I pretty much take them everywhere with me. And this is a new flavor. Here we go. I think it might be a little bit melted. Dang it. Okay, so definitely got a little bit melted out in the sun, but let's give it a try. Key lime pie. Here we go. Oh man. Every single flavor is good. I love the crispy, light texture of these bars, and they have a good amount of whey protein, and they just always deliver. I am getting ready for dinner, and tonight I have a homemade backpacking meal. I've been making all my own backpacking food for years now with a dehydrator at home, and today I have a teriyaki chicken and rice that I am testing. It has some chicken, rice, as the name implies, and then some freeze-dried veggies in here and a teriyaki sauce. I am really, really excited about this one. You guys have been asking for more backpacking food recipes, and I am on it. I'm actually testing this one now. I have a couple that I have tested a few times now, so I'm hoping this winter I'll actually come out with a little bit more backpacking food resources for you guys. In the description box below, I will put a video I made on how to make backpacking food. It's kind of a, you know, beginner's guide to making pasta with a dehydrator. So I will link to that below. But yeah, today, teriyaki chicken and rice, I'm excited. This is what it looks like dehydrated before I add hot water. Mostly just rice and chicken. All right. So after about 20-25 minutes, let's see, I think it's done. Oh yeah. So that is the finished product. I wouldn't say it like looks amazing, but the taste test is really what it's all about. It's pretty good. The chicken is not as rehydrated as I would like. I think I need to just let it sit for a little bit longer. Let me try one bite. Hot. It's pretty good. For dessert, I'm having one of these little Rice Krispie treats. I tried one last night and I don't think I'd really buy them again, honestly, but they are a really nice little sweet treat for after dinner, and I always need some dessert after dinner. So that's what I got here, strawberries and cream flavor. So that is it for what I ate today out adventuring in the backcountry. I hope you enjoyed this video and got some meal ideas for your next trip. If you like this video, make sure to give it a like and subscribe to my channel before you go. I upload new videos just about every single week all about the great outdoors. I will catch you in the next one. Peace.